Hello, IT. Have you tried turning it off and on again? Oh, okay, well, the button on the side, is it glowing? Yeah, you need to turn it on. The button turns it on? Yeah. You do know how a button works, don't you? No, not on clothes.
Hello, IT. Yeah-huh. Have you tried forcing an unexpected reboot?
No, there you go. No, there you go. I just heard it come on. No, that's the music you hear when it comes on. No, that's the music you hear when... I'm sorry, are you from the past?
You see, the driver hooks a function by patching the system call table, so it's not safe to unload it unless another thread's about to jump in there and do its stuff, and you don't want to end up in the middle of invalid memory. Hello?
Oh, really? Really? Well, why don't you come down here and make me then? Huh? What, you think I'm afraid of you? I'm not afraid of you! You can come down here any time and I'll be waiting for you. I told her. Oh, God, it's about time you got back. It's been all go.
You had a job?
Girl on fifth.
Did you and her hit it off?
Define hit it off?
Did she continue talking to you once you'd fixed her computer?
No.
Now let's learn some of the most important vocabulary and pronunciation. So, before we jump into today's lesson, if you guys want to learn more about how to really improve your English with TV series and all your favorite shows, sign up to our free 3-part mini course teaching you all the most fundamental aspects of learning English with TV series. Have you tried? In this case, tried is asking if you have tested something in order to get a certain result. The example: have you tried taking a painkiller for your headache? Turn on, turn off, to activate, cause to flow, generally with electricity and water. Example: don't forget to turn the water off while brushing your teeth. Glowing, to be bright and shining, radiating, letting off light in a pulsating way. Example: his t-shirt was glowing under the black light. How buttons work. Work in this case means how they function, what they are used for. Example: he doesn't know how the iron works. Don't you? This is a question tag turning an affirmation into a question at the end. The example is: you work in the city, don't you? So, you work in the city, the original question would be: do you work in the city? That's why I use the do negative, don't you? Not on clothes. The person on the phone is mistaking the button to turn on a computer for a button on clothes. Example: the button fell off my new t-shirt last night. Unexpected reboot. The character Moss is a typical IT nerd. Instead of saying restart, he uses this term. There you go. This expression is commonly used to say that someone has accomplished something. Example: there you go, you did it. Congratulations. Come on, when something starts to happen or work. The air conditioner comes on at 9 a.m. Why don't you? Or with connected speech, why don't you? Why don't you? This question is asked with an intention of motivating or provoking someone. An example: well, why don't you go and tell him how bad his food is? Make me then, to force somebody to do something with physical or psychological power. Example: she made him apologize to his mother for the mess. That told her. This expression is used after you have yelled at someone or proved them wrong in some way. Example: that really told him when you expressed why you were angry. It's about time, used to express the urgency of someone's arrival. Example: it's about time you got here. The game is starting. To get back, to return to a place. Example: he got back from his trip 2 days ago. To be all go means to be very eventful, to have lots of things happening. The example is: it was all go at the bar last night. The girl on fifth is the woman working on the fifth floor of the building because the IT guys work from the basement, the bottom floor. To hit it off, hit it off, or with connected speech, hit it off, hit it off. It means to have a strong connection with someone as soon as you meet them, and it's often in a romantic way. The example, they really hit it off at the party last night. And lastly, once. Not once meaning one time. In this case, it's a more formal way to say after, but it's not used in all cases. For example, once I've finished painting, I will wash the floor. So that means after I finish painting, I will wash the floor. Remember, these guys are speaking with English and Scottish accents, so it might take a little while to really understand them, but it's a very enjoyable show, and if you guys have time to check it out, I definitely suggest watching it and using it to really help your English fluency. So now let's watch the scene one more time, and you're going to be amazed by how much you can actually understand. Oh yeah.
Hello, IT. Have you tried turning it off and on again? Okay, well, the button on the side, is it glowing? Yeah, you need to turn it on. The button turns it on? Yeah. You do know how a button works, don't you? No, not on clothes.
Hello, IT. Yeah, huh? Have you tried forcing an unexpected reboot?
No, there you go. I just heard it come on. No, that's the music you hear when it comes on. I'm sorry, are you from the past?
You see, the driver hooks a function by patching the system call table, so it's not safe to unload it unless another thread's about to jump in there and do its stuff, and you don't want to end up in the middle of invalid memory. Hello?
Oh, really? Well, why don't you come down here and make me then? Huh? What, you think I'm afraid of you? I'm not afraid of you! You can come down here any time and I'll be waiting for you.
I told her.
Oh, God, it's about time you got back. It's been all go.
You had a job?
Girl on fifth.
Did you and her hit it off?
Define hit it off?
Did she continue talking to you once you'd fixed her computer?
No.